During her interpellation of the Office of the President's proposal for an 8.1 billion peso budget in 2022, Gabriela Women's Party's Representative Arlene Rosas claimed there's about 386 billion in the 2022 budget that the president can use in his campaign for vice president. That includes confidential and intelligence funds, funds for local government units, contingent funds, and even the 10 billion peso growth equity fund for poor local governments.
The Office of the President is sitting on a 385.77 billion pork barrel war chest in the run-up to the 2022 election, which means that a sizable chunk of the 5 trillion proposed budget are discretionary funds of the President.
Zamboanga del Norte 1st District Representative Romeo Halosos Jr., who defended the OP's budget, however, pointed out there are safeguards to ensure the funds will be used for the intended purpose.
The GF shall be released to the LGUs in accordance with the implementing rules and regularities to be prescribed by the Development Budget Coordinating Committee. It shall be subject to the mechanism and guidelines.
But Bayan Muna Representative Carlos Zarate is unconvinced. He also believes the whole 2022 budget could be used by the president for the election, should there be a reenacted budget. Zarate explained that in a reenacted budget, all safeguards and limitations to spending are dispensed with. But congressional leaders assured this won't happen. We intend to approve the budget on third and final reading Thursday, in time for Congress adjourning by Friday till November 7th for the filing of candidacies for the 2022 elections. They can avoid a reenacted budget, which last happened in 2018, after the House finished the budget November that year, depriving the Senate time to approve it before the new year. The House on Wednesday received President Duterte's certification to the necessity of the spending plan, allowing lawmakers to approve the bill on second, third, and final reading on the same day. This despite concern from the Makabayan bloc that the budget is being railroaded, depriving them of an opportunity to scrutinize and make changes. Aside from the OP's budget, the plenary session also finished the budget deliberations for the Commission on Senior Citizens, the Department of Social Welfare and Development, and the Department of Education. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.